Now, it's interesting that you chose chapter 13. So what I'd like to do is take a step back and set the stage. And I'm going to start with chapter 7. Now, chapter 7 has a list. Actually, it appears in chapter 5 of the Bankruptcy Code, section 523A, has a list of debts that are not dischargeable in a chapter 7. Among those are debts that you have to an entity that you got money from that entity to pay a non-dischargeable tax debt. That debt is not dischargeable in that chapter 7. In other words, you can't decide, well, I know I can't get rid of the tax debt, but I'll just pop that tax debt on my Visa card, and then it'll just be a credit card debt, and it'll be discharged in the bankruptcy. Well, no, that doesn't work out. Debt that you incurred to pay the non-dischargeable tax debt is not dischargeable in Chapter 7. That's the same in Chapter 11, by the way, because the list of non-dischargeable debts in Chapter 11 is the same as the list of non-dischargeable debts in Chapter 7 for the individual debtor in Chapter 11. But Chapter 13 has a shorter list. If you get the discharge in Chapter 13 after plan completion, if you get a hardship discharge, and we talked about that a little bit ago in Chapter 13, then the list of non-dischargeable debts is the same as in Chapter 7. But it's a shorter list for Chapter 13 discharges where you complete the plan. Some of the things that are listed in as non-dischargeable debts in Chapter 7 are not included in Chapter 13. Among those are debts that you incur to pay a tax. So those you can discharge in a Chapter 13, provided you complete the plan. If you don't complete the plan, then they're not going to be dischargeable. But as long as you complete the plan, they are dischargeable, meaning that you don't have to pay them in full. They get paid at whatever percentage the general and secureds get paid. Interestingly enough, there are a couple of others that are dischargeable in Chapter 13 that are not dischargeable in Chapter 7, one of which I think we're going to be getting to in just a little bit. So you can call the Chapter 13 discharge sort of a super discharge. In fact, at one point, fraud debts were dischargeable in Chapter 13, though they've never been dischargeable in Chapter 7. But then in 2005, that changed. So the fraud debt, unfortunately, well, depending on your perspective, if you're the creditor, this is fortunate, is not dischargeable in a Chapter 13. But in any event, answer to your question is yes, you can discharge debts incurred to pay a non-dischargeable tax in a Chapter 13, but not in any other chapter.